Chippewa Musical, Fame Goody. We hope you enjoy the show. But for everyone who enjoyed the show, here are a few reminders of musical etiquette.
Please silence all cell phones and or photography or videography. There are 6 exits, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. To help keep things moving at the end of the show, please use any of the 6.
Speaking of exits, you may find yourself having to make a very important call, like you're a surgeon on call. If this is the case, please just make your way to one of the exits.
Again, please turn off all cell phones
and enjoy the show. Jose.
right place.
You're in the right place, but at the wrong time. Mr. Jackson, are you going to the beach or coming to school? And no headphones.
Get off my case. It's my first day. Lady.
Keep it up. It could be your last. My name's not Lee. It's Miss Sherman. Oh.
Thank you. Knock it off, guys. If we're going to be a band, we've got to get along. Excuse me, Mr. Sheinkopf. We'd like to work together on freshman ensemble. Percussion, trumpet, violin, what kind of music would you play?
New wave!
Funk! Classic rock!
Maybe a little disco? We're starting a band! Boy, it's going to be a long year!
Excuse me, but aren't you that guy from that peanut butter commercial?
Yeah, but do me a favor, don't spread it around.
Why not? I killed to have a national commercial in the air.
You sound like my mom. She's been dragging me around to audition since I was 3.
I wish I had a mom like that.
Trust me, you don't.
My name's Serena Katz.
I know, I saw you in Homer.
Do you think, I hate to impose, but could I have your autograph?
Look, I'm sorry. I came here so I can concentrate on my studies.
But why? You're already a pro. I bet you've even already got your actor's equity card.
I know, but I want to be a real actor, not some TV hack. Have you heard of Stanislavski?
Stan who?
Konstantin Stanislavski. He invented the Moscow Art Studio in 1897. He and his friends struggled and starved, but that was okay, because they believed in what they were doing.
Wow, you're really into this.
You have to be. The work, the craft, that's all that really matters. Listen to this. The actor must learn to use the magical if. What if, from the moment of the appearance of this if, the actor passes from a plane of actual reality into a plane of another life, created and imagined by himself. Believing in this life, the actor can begin to recreate. Wanna make magic. I want to breathe fire on stage. I want to make every single line jump right off the page. I want to make magic. I want to electrify the place. I want to be more than just a fool.
Gently, ladies, gently, your ballerina, not
talk about it. Tyrone.
We study classical dance from the same room as study home, sir. To build technique and to learn classic form. Think of it as a museum.
But why does it have to be like that? Why can't you do ballet different? Switched on, tight wire, like traffic at Times Square.
Sounds like you've given this a lot of thought.
Oh, Tyrone, some more than think about it. He came up with a whole new dance.
So?
So, I think we've got a budding choreographer in our midst.
Watch out, ballet world.
I still have no future in ballet.
Well, maybe you would, if you worked harder.
Hey, I work as hard as anyone, but be honest. When was the last time you saw someone like me dancing in the core of ballet?
It's not your dancing that's the problem, Mr. Tyrone Jackson. It's your attitude.
You don't know me, so stop shoving your silver spoon down my throat.
Tyrone, wait. You and everyone else at the school have been making assumptions about me. I heard you. You know what? I'm not rich. My family barely has enough money to keep me in pointe shoes.
Yeah, right. That's why we show up every day in that long black limo.
My father's a chauffeur. He drives me here on his way to work. And I don't speak French either. I barely even know what merci madame means.
Then how come you're putting on this act?
Because I was scared.
Scared of what? The best dancer in the school, Iris.
Scared no one who liked me.
Well, I like you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
She's passing you. Such a lovely way to be, and I want to say.
Tyrone and I study together. So what if the papers are similar?
They weren't similar. They were identical.
Then why not accuse Iris?
Because she's a straight-A student. Let's be honest. Iris has been carrying you in your academic subjects for the entire year.
Nobody cares me. I do my own work in my own way.
You may think you do, but your reading is substandard. You couldn't possibly have written that paper.
Hey, forget this noise. I don't want to be no festival anyway.
Tyrone, wait. Wait.
You're not being fair, Esther! Tyrone is hard in my class. He's motivated in my class. This young man has the potential to become a true artist.
A true artist that can hardly read. Let Tyrone pass his academic subjects. Then we'll talk about his living in the art.
No! We'll talk about it now!
Art is special to let you fool. Special to sit down, we'll bring in the fools. Biblical complaining.
What? Teachers aren't some sort of alien race. Maybe Mars could help you.
I mean, what? You think I got some kind of problem?
No, I mean, yeah, I mean, maybe you do. It's just all this stuff about being famous all the time. Maybe you should take a break from that.
Look, Mr. Medicine Mom, Mr. Son of the Famous Violin Virtuoso. Some people get life handed to them on the silver tray. The rest of us have to reach out and grab it.
Carmen, wait. I'm sorry. We didn't mean to make you angry. We wish you didn't feel like you had to fight all the time.
I'm a survivor. That's who I am. Take it or leave it.
Okay, we'll take it. We'll take it.
Wait a minute. What did you say?
I said we'll take it. Carmen, don't you know, good times are bad, we're a team. Hey, we finished that song we were working on. It turned out pretty good.
Well, of course it did. With my words and your music, how could we lose?
Mom, we'll play for you. The conductor is the conduit between the pit and the stage. So keep one eye on the music, with the other eye on me.
Supposed to be cast as for a show. Looks like you'll be playing Juliet.
you serious? Oh my gosh. You are serious? I don't believe it. Juliet. I play Juliet as in Romeo and my parents are gonna flop.
Look, I'm sorry about last year. Throwing myself at you like that, I was so immature. But this year I plan to be much more focused on work.
Serena, I'm not mad at you. I care more about you than anyone else in this whole school.
You do?
Yeah, I do.
Good. Then we can be girlfriend and boyfriend on stage and friends off.
Well, I've been cast as Romeo. I've been cast as Mercutio.
A plague on both their houses, they may harm me of me.
You already know your lines?
I've been doing Shakespeare since I was in grade school.
See you at rehearsal, Serena. Wait a minute. If Nick's playing Mercutio, then who's playing Romeo?
No! What is this? A kill him, I'll swear I killed him! He knows I hate Shakespeare! Why are you doing
in the teacher's lounge.
Carmen, I know you have your difficulties at PA, but believe me, nobody's happy to see me.
Oh yeah? Wish I could say the feeling's mutual.
Carmen, your anger has to be your greatest asset. It has to be used for you instead of against you. Look, I can't make you stay.
But if you leave, you'll be making the biggest mistake of your life. So, you made up your mind. You would
less hear about it. Please don't you start bugging me, too.
Carmen, we're your friends. We care what happens to you.
Then be my friends and get off my case.
But you already know this guy.
Ellie Green came to New York to scout talent, and he found me. He has faith in me, which is more than I have to say for you.
What about the band? What about us?
I can't pass this up. Besides, the band ain't going nowhere.
Who says it's a showbiz?
He's a professional agent. He's got all kinds of things lined up for me on LA.
You know what your problem is? You want everything too fast. Instant fame. Unfortunately, that only happens with fairy tales.
You know, Carmen, the four of us, we could really bend some.
Save me from Maybe it would. lips, my prayer's effect I take. By nine, my sin is purged.
Well, let's see a show of hands. How many of you like this Romeo? Romeo, you got your wish. Juliet, meet your new Romeo.
Hello, Romeo.
Send me all semester. Why is that, Iris?
Okay, I'll make it simple. I don't want to be the loser. Because what does that make me?
Oh, I get it. I see what this is about.
You use me, Tyrone. All those book reports I helped you with, why did you tell me you couldn't read?
What was I supposed to say? Hey, baby, come get me. I'm illiterate. Iris, you don't know what it's like. When you look at a book, you see words. When I look, I see garbage. I see noise. Thanks for Sherman. That noise started sounding like music. Listen to this. Celebrate myself and sing myself. And what I assume, you shall assume. For every atom belonging to me, as good belongs to you. What women? He's a grass.
That's great, Tyrone. It's just one poem.
I'm not taking the easy way out. I'm repeating my senior year. I'll be the first to graduate from the new Lincoln Center School. I'm not a loser, Iris.
Our senior song written by a very talented student, Carmen Diaz.
This is for you, Carmen. We'll always remember your name.
We have arrived at a moment in our lives where the future passes into our hands.
We can find out, are we really strong enough to fulfill what the future demands?
We can stand on the edge and look out into space and beyond by the water we see.
We can all make a pledge.
Understand that this world that we know
We'll start off. The two probably most important people of this whole production are Mrs. Hoyhtya and Mrs. Keeley. So, Mrs. by the way, I don't know if you guys know that, but my mom and Mrs. Keeney. They're just so amazing, and they work so well together, and we're just all so thankful for them. Right, guys? Right? Getting all of our tech stuff done, so we didn't think he'd be a huge flower fan, so we got him.
Okay, I have quite a bit to say, actually, so I'm just going to start and go through my little list here. I'm more nervous about this than I have been anything in a really long time, so bear with me. First, I just want to start by thanking our amazing new principal, Rob Reetz, and MaryEllen. It's MaryEllen and Rob and Tucker, if he's in here anywhere. If you guys could just come up here really quick. And, amazing opportunity, and I'm not going to make it through this, but I will never forget sitting down and being offered this opportunity, not fully understanding it, and then getting an email from Rob saying, so excited to have you on board, and I thought I'd like had to go through an interview process or something, and I quickly replied back, I've never done this before, so I just want you to know I really don't have a clue what I'm doing. And he was so ready to take the risk of a rookie director, and it has truly been one of the most amazing experiences of my life. Well, Trigby's right there. Cute story. I was in one of my very panicky moments, and we were going to meet with Trigby to talk over just the mics and the lights and all the technical aspects. And Emma goes, Mom, you'll feel better when you talk to Trigby. He'll make everything be okay. And I did. You just have such a calming presence, and I'm so grateful for your help. When I thought about doing this, I thought I can only do it if Trigby will help me. So, and here you are. So. Story. Amber choreographed a little dance to Thriller when our daughters were in fourth grade together, and she really struck me as this fun-loving, really cool mom. And now fast forward a couple of years, and there was some confusion on whether just her name came up, and I'm like, hey, can you hold her? I was going to ask her to choreograph. And so I called her up, or emailed her, and her response was, I have been dreaming of choreographing fame my whole life. Truly, this is amazing. Your energy and your creativity, any little extra things you've seen were Amber. So thank you so much. I totally forgot to put Sam Keeler's name on the program. Ellie, Ms. Bell, her brother came in and kind of guest directed for a week, worked with the boys, taught the kids like character warm-ups that are still being practiced in the car as we drive around and talked about. So just a really special help he was. And then moving into the rest of my assistant directors, Maddie Smith and McKenna Page. people, they were very quick to jump in and just offer their expertise and insights and ideas, and just have been a great moral support to all of us here. Thank you, girls. Liza and Claire. Is Claire out? No, she's not here. Oh, yes, there's a high school dance.
Liza!
Liza jumped in and started working with the set and the backstage. She's essentially been the backstage director and helped all the kids get really fired up about being backstage, and has done a fantastic job. Thank you, Liza. From Joe Vegas, Jose, all of his little moves, just a ball of energy, lots and lots of hard work, and hours of thinking about the play and putting everything onto the stage. So she's been phenomenal. It was her mom, Anne, who I think is here tonight, who helped me cast, who I'm so grateful for her help, who was like, made sure that I got a good choreographer, and I did that with Amber. So, but Gracie is her daughter, and your family has made an imprint in this whole production, so thank you. To Emma. When I was trying to decide if this was something I could do, I would get very, very worried and worked up, and I'd go, one minute I'd be like, yeah, I think this would be really fun, and the next minute I'd feel completely inadequate and say, I have no idea, I don't know what to do, and she'd just say, but Mom, I do, I know what to do. totally would put me at ease and helped me so much. On the first day of practice, she was supposed to go skiing, and I was in a total worried about what to do, and I texted her, what do I do? How do I start this thing off? And she gave me ideas, and then finally she said, Mom, do you want me to be there? And I said, yeah. And she skipped skiing, and she came to the first practice, and has just been such a hard worker, and man, the UK. Very importantly, thank you all the parents, all you guys, being amazing. Thank you for being patient with me. All my crazy, forgetful emails with last-minute things, and in helping my two kids in the play remember things and forgetting it all the time, I realized how much you guys do. It was almost harder being the parent than it was directing at times because I kept forgetting everything. So you guys are amazing. Truly, thanks for the rides and for rolling with this, and just being so incredibly supportive. So, and finally, I just want to thank all of you guys. These kids are so talented, so devoted, so amazing. My husband took many, many pictures the first night, and of all of the kids, all the different backs. Come back to Sam, her flowers are right here. I'll finish up with the kids, anyway, my hardest job was just keeping you quiet, as you can all tell, but the fact that was the hardest thing to do shows how much energy, that energy all came out on stage, and all the pictures that we have of every single person staying in character throughout the whole time, it's just so incredibly fun to work with you guys. I will be very bored at 3:00 every day. I will miss you. You might come and find me in the auditorium.
There we go. Every day. Watch it.
Sam. she was just my go-to person. The kids would come to me and say, what do I wear for this? And what do you want me to do for this? And I'd say, just talk to Sam. I don't know, talk to Sam. She just did such a fabulous job and really took this and made it a very, very special thing. I cataloged costumes and organized it and spent hours working very, very, very hard. And when I asked Emma, so do you know Sam Gearney? What do you think of her? And she goes, class act. And you really have been a class act. So it's been such a pleasure.
Okay.
Most improved in acting, the voice is...
accounted for in the number that we have. Is Alex Smith for being Maddie's brother? So yeah. Come on up.
Foreshadowing thing, Isaac. Just kidding. That was a joke.
Wait, wait, wait.
Well,
so talented and so worth it.
Of the Shoreview Community Center. Okay?
Wow.
And my mom goes, Emma, I have some pretty weird moves. And I'm like, what now, right? And she goes, I actually was asked to do the Chippewa show. Mrs. Hershey will be doing it this year.
But then I was like, oh crap, because I thought it was about baseball managing, because we managed baseball together.
Baseball's cool.
And I almost died inside. But then I didn't, because she was like, my mom's doing this. And I was like, woo, and they yelled really loud, and then I got a lot of weird looks, and yeah.
Thank you for trying to raise
Great. I think there are parents that are here to pick you guys. Do not leave as I say this, okay? If you guys have to, can stay and have time, if you need to, if your parents are bringing you to Jessica's house, I understand. But if you want to share your very quick little encouragement of the other people, maybe just raise your hand and stand up.
She's holding my hand, and they end their song. Where's Ellie? Ellie. And they end their song, and she starts bawling. She starts bawling and squeezing my hand.
I know.
Like,
oh, that was
so true. You guys are amazing.
Daniel's hand is now broken.
Yeah.
And tonight, when backstage crew and my people were on stage, I actually started crying because I do not want this to end, and I was so happy that you guys
played.
I was crying for like 15 minutes.
By the way, she never cries.
I don't cry a lot, and I just did not want this to end. It was just so much fun. I just love being with all you and getting to know you all better.
I just want to say,
I really think I like ended on a high note because I'm in 8th grade, and I hope all of you other 8th graders that you've ended on a high note. Thank you for making this so wonderful.
I believe there is one more.
Law 1. That should be best out today. For the best director in the play ever.
Like I know. So that's good.
Olivia Hoyhtya, because a lot of my family and friends saw this play, and they're all like, did you see Olivia? She's up there having so much fun. And so I just want to give her a shout out because everyone who saw it said, she was super nervous and she was freaking out that she wasn't gonna do anything. And her friends were here and she was just freaking out. And then she went on stage and she did like the best performances ever.
So, you guys are all amazing. 6th, 7th, 8th grade, whatever. We have a quick story for you. Me and her auditioned in 6th grade and we didn't even make it.
It turned out it was more musical grade than grade musical.
And so I was like, oh, I'm just gonna fake it. This isn't really fun. And then it started getting better and better and better and better. And then on the last performance, I decided, oh, wow, this is, I guess I have to do this next year.
Whoa!
Because I really don't know what I'm gonna do without it.
I'm gonna be cannibal. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Nope.
You're a cannibal?
talking to our nice cameraman here.
That's me.
Eat him.
If you okay?
Eat him. You kid him.
No, no.
Hi, I'm Kate.
I'm Maddie,
and this is your Chippewa student musical
from the tech crew's point of view.
Tech crew.
You probably don't know we exist.
Probably not.
This is all we get.
This is all we get. You know, tech crew, it's I should have probably asked you. But you see, you should really appreciate the tech crew because we do everything.
We get here like 2 hours ago.
Let's face it, without us,
we're
this
here
would
till
be
like
a mess.
5:36.
They still talking. It's my turn. No, I want to say something. Okay, I'm in charge of mics.
I'm in charge of you guys. I'm the only person doing spot, and honestly, if you guys don't complain about
stage
the shakiness
better.
Of it, because literally,
it's hard.
You will get it in a spot, and then it'll be like, oh, I'm just gonna stay stuck here and like annoy you
and not move
and like make you look bad.
And
Adam, get in here.
Don't start. What is it,
Maddie?
Oh yeah.
So yeah, hey, this is Adam
serious.
Higley.
Woo! I'm gonna
Adam,
this thing bigger.
We're all gonna say our names. Let's all say our names.
Hey guys, we're tech crew for the musical this year. I'm Maddie. This is
we're
Kate.
Late.
And Adam and Merrick, and there's a lot more of us like
everywhere.
There yeah. somewhere. Trains
over we're just invisible. And that's
the one decided
to over there.
We're annoying.
Adam is usually up
here. I will ask the questions now because this isn't working. Oh, we're locking.
Bye.
All right. Oh, okay then. Have you enjoyed working on Fame Jr.?
Yes.
No.
Yeah, it was really fun.
Yeah, I guess.
Did you like the show?
Yeah, I thought the show went really well.
Yeah,
it was awesome.
I think some improvements there and here and there.
Here, guys.
Here and there. You know. I really liked the musical, you know.
Smile, please.
Amazing. It was great. It was awesome.
Look at the camera smile at least
final
once.
Words.
We're in
yes.
the show. Obviously,
yeah.
yes.
I loved the show.
It was amazing. Everyone did so amazing. They were so energetic and alive. And the dances were just phenomenal.
I did like the show, and I thought that the director, beautiful woman, I'd marry her. I did marry her.
Bomb.com. Especially Jack Hedges.
My favorite Nick. Character would be Nick because
Jack
he's played Manley. By Jack Hedges.
He did a great role.
He's an amateur actor, but he's bringing his character to life.
I would definitely say Serena. I'm not gonna,
very good.
Because she's a really good singer.
Yes,
she's
really talented.
She thinks
she's an upcoming artist.
Yeah. So, Amira, if you see this in the future, shout out to your girl Mandy. You don't even know what that means.
Okay, my favorite character. My daughter's on the show, so she was my favorite character. She played Raven. But, honestly, I love them all. I know that sounds so cheesy, but I love them all.
Well, I really did think Will Conlin did a great job.
Jose?
Yes, as Jose, as Joe.
I do enjoy my character, yes, but if I had any other part, I'd probably like Nick, and if I was a girl, I'd probably like Eden's role, whatever her name is, something like that.
What was your favorite scene?
Probably Mable's prayer, because Mable's literally me.
What was your favorite scene?
Okay, so I'm the choreographer. My name's Amber. And I had a great time working with all these kids, a lot of them who've never danced before. And the most exciting thing for me was There She Goes, because everybody danced their hearts out, sang their hearts out. I loved how the scene changed in so many ways. And the tech people did the lights so well that it made everything that everyone was doing on stage just totally pop. I was so sad when it was over, because I just love it and I want to see it every day for the rest of my life.
Like, what was your favorite scene?
I liked probably the junior festival. But, I think it's really well rehearsed. The choreography is good. The singing is good. And everyone's out on stage. That's really fun for the entire cast.
The whole thing was just fabulous and amazing. You should come see it. It was amazing.
Lily, what do you think?
Honestly, my two favorite, I can't pick between one. Either the teacher argument scene or the dance scene after the lunchroom. Those two scenes are just amazing.
All of it. I actually liked Mabel's prayer a lot. Just the really high notes and just the funny thing that Nina's really skinny. And like, yeah, just, it was really funny. And Nina's
no time for losers, cause we
okay, Russo.
My scene, teacher's argument.
Oh, my favorite scene to work on was probably the lunchroom scene because, you know, it was fun, you know?
I don't know. I just loved building the set, and the set was on for the whole thing, so I liked all of it.
Well, I didn't really get to work on many scenes. I'm just doing my changes, but my favorite scene to see them work on was probably the lunchroom scene.
Why didn't you put videos of me on your story?
Oh, I have like 10. I don't know.
They're all good.
Yeah, why?
My favorite scene by far was the Carmen scene because it was just really fun to learn.
Energetic.
It was really energetic.
Favorite text.
What was your favorite scene?
Her scene, Carmen.
Oh.
I said me.
I know. You said her scene and then you said every
scene. But I like your scene like, when you're like, cool. Yeah.
It's like, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
A teacher's argument.
Yes!
It's great.
It's a great experience.
Thank you. Thank you.
I love the lunch scene because I get to slide across the table and that's really fun.
The teacher's argument was pretty good today.
And the lunch scene.
All the scenes. I mean, they did a really great job.
But the lunch scene has never been that, or the teacher scene argument.
Teacher's argument. Oh, that was
the best it's ever been. Like, so powerful.
I think I was pretty great. I'm always great, but today I was super great.
The best scene by far was the teacher's argument. It was really good. And I liked how angry they got.
There she goes, actually, still in the lunchroom.
I like the first scene. That's so fun.
Thank you very much.
What did you do as the tech?
I guess, basically what I did was I facilitated the sound and light equipment for the show, and then gave some design input. I guess I tried to leave a lot of it up to the students because it's their show, and they did a great job working with getting the mic schedules made, getting the sound system set up, and getting a really good lighting design for the show.
Well, I just helped bring things on and off and kind of directed people around and like where to go. So, yeah, it was pretty fun. I really enjoyed it.
Do you think Xavier the DVXer?
That was really creepy what you just said. That's what I have to say.
Luckily, none of
you. Do you have anything to say at all for the DVs?
Nope.
What you looking at online?
I don't know.
Nice job!
Wait, do you have anything to say?
Paparazzi, no.
It's been a great experience. I really want to thank Lea for giving me this chance. And I think it was just great choreograph and everything was great.
Okay, so it was really hot. I had a great time. Everybody was so really happy. Okay, goodbye.
If these are your shoes, you left them in the guys' dressing room. Pick them up. I don't know whose they are. Take care of your stuff. Get your shoes.
Well, I'd like to thank you all for listening to me because I'm really bad and sorry that you have to listen to this. But thank you for dealing with me for 2 months. That's all I really got to say at this point. Thank you.
I actually regret not trying out because I really wish I was out there. And I went out there several times just as like a cameo type person, but I really wish I would have tried out instead.
You know, it was pretty great. Yellow sweat and muffin.
Thanks, Merrick, for this amazing. amazing interview. I feel special and I feel like I'm a Kardashian.
It's a great production and, you know, it's a great production.
Thanks for supporting it. Yeah.
Okay. Well, so I was just like with the backstage crew, but the whole cast, they took me in as a family. It was just amazing. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. I don't know what I'm talking into, but thank you, Merrick, for being amazing behind the scenes. Nobody shouted you out, so I will. You are awesome, and I was really gonna cry, so I didn't want to say a speech because my cry face is like three times worse than Kim Kardashian. So, Swag Money, we're all awesome.
I want to thank my producers, Mrs. Hoyhtya and Emma Hoyhtya and Sam and Liza and Gracie.
I would like to personally thank you for throwing this party. Says, yeah, the after party. Yes, thank you.
I love you all. It was a fantastic experience. Can't wait till next year. You're amazing. Really made me proud. My heart pitter patters every time I watch you. Great job.
You guys, in the future, you might be old, you might be young still. I don't know, but I love you so much. You are all so talented. Don't interrupt me. You are so talented, and I just love you guys so much, and I just want you all to know that you are so talented, and you're going to do amazing things in life, and don't forget about me when you're famous.
We believe in you.
We believe in
Buy
you.
Buy me a car.
XOXO. Emma.
Thank you, Lea Hoyhtya, for this awesome experience. And thank you guys. I might seem mean, but I hope I'm not. Yay! Love you. Nice job, everybody.
Hola, ¿cómo está?
This might all go into the DVD, so.
Sweet, I don't care. How's it going? I'm great. All right. How great? How are you?
That's good.
Bye.
Seen her in a small cafe.
Better lock the doors and turn the lights, hello. Doors and turn the lights, hello. Doors and turn the lights, hello.
Can you do mine again?
Play some music, man. Neon shit.
Oh, that's my solo.
I'm Joe. It's Joe Lee.
Oh, no, it's here.
I say better. Yo, dog.
Tyrone passes academic subjects.
He
then we'll talk about it something in the arts. Yeah.
That is horribly
incorrect. Nice. Let Tyrone pass his academic standards. Then we will talk about his future in the arts.
Oh my gosh, you are serious. I don't believe it. Juliet, I'm playing Juliet, as in Romeo and... No, my parents are gonna applaud.
It doesn't zoom out anymore. I need to put a wide angle in this thing, okay.
Keep talking. Is it on?
Are you working?
Here.
Is mine working?
Hello. Hello.
What?
this year's Chippewa musical, Fame Junior. We hope you enjoy the show. But for everyone to enjoy the show, here are a few reminders of musical etiquette.
Please silence all cell phones and or small children. No flash photography or videography. There are 6 exits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. To help keep things moving at the end of the show, please use any of the 6.
Speaking of exits, you may find yourself having to make a very important call, like you're a surgeon on call. If this is the case, please just make your way to one of the exits.
Again, please turn off all cell phones.
And enjoy the show.
Schlomo, here.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Metzenbaum. I'm a big fan of your father's.
Great. Glad one of us is.
It's my first day, Lee.
Keep it up. It could be your last. My name's not Lee. It's Miss Sherman.
Oh! I'm alive. Show the world that I can take it. And I can
every morning. Students are expected to arrive dressed and ready to dance.
this? A shopping list? Participation in the dance program requires specific attire, including tights, leotards, leg warmers, and specialized footwear.
Character shoes, jazz shoes, point shoes? Who do you think I am? Imelda Marcos?
Luckily, we have received a generous grant from the National Endowment to help cover the cost.
Hey, Lamb Chops. Goody, this is the drummer I was telling you about.
But she's a girl.
You got a problem with that?
No, I like girls. It's just like it's nervous when they got sticks in their hands.
Knock it off, guys. If we're gonna be a band, you gotta get along. Excuse me, Mr. Sheinkopf. We'd like to work together on a freshman ensemble. Percussion, trumpets, violin, what kind of music would you play?
New wave!
Funk!
Classic rock!
Maybe a little disco? We're starting a band! Boy, it's going to be a long year!
Peanut butter commercial?
Yeah, but do me a favor, don't spread it around.
Why not? I killed to have a national commercial in the air.
You sound like my mom. She's been dragging me around to audition since I was 3.
I wish I had a mom like that.
Trust me, you don't.
My name's Serena Katz.
I know, I saw you in homeroom.
Do you think, I hate to impose, but could I have your autograph?
Look, I'm sorry. I came here so I can concentrate on my studies.
But why? You're already a pro. I bet you've even already got your actor's equity card.
I know, but I want to be a real actor, not some TV hack. Have you heard of Stanislavski?
Stan who?
Konstantin Stanislavski. He invented the Moscow Art Studio in 1897. He and his friends struggled and starved, but that was okay because they believed in what they were doing.
Wow, you're really into this?
You have to be. The work, the craft, that's all that really matters. Listen to this. The actor must learn to use the magical if. What if, from the moment of the appearance of this if, the actor passes from a plane of actual reality into a plane of another life, created and imagined by himself. Believing in this life, the actor can begin to create. Wanna make magic. Want to breathe fire on the stage. I want to make every single line jump right off the page. I want to make magic. I want to electrify the place. I want to be more than just a
Trust me, Mable. That girl,
Ain't no scum.
Put your eyes back in your head, Tyrone. She's way out of your league.
Says who?
Says that shiny black limo that dropped her off just before homeroom. All right, everyone, let's take it from the top. Thank you for joining us, Carmen.
Sorry, Miss Bell.
Got hung up on the subway.
Keep the movements fluid, ready, and... Imagine crystal clear water flowing gently down the street. Mabel! I said water, not molasses. What's wrong with you today?
I feel faint. I hadn't had a thing to eat since breakfast.
It's only 9:45.
So? I don't care what time it is, my stomach's screaming. Feed me, feed me.
Hang in there, Mabel. Only 3.5 more hours.
Be like that. Why can't you do ballet different? Switched on, tight wire, like traffic at Times Square.
Sounds like you've given this a lot of thought.
Oh, Tyrone's more than think about it. He came up with a whole new dance.
So?
So, I think we've got a budding choreographer in our midst.
Watch out, ballet world.
I still don't have no future in ballet.
Well, maybe you would if you worked harder.
Hey, I work as hard as anyone, but be honest. When was the last time you saw someone like me dancing the court of ballet?
It's not your dance that's the problem, Mr. Tyrone Jackson. It's your attitude.
You don't know me. Stop shoving your silver spoon down my throat.
Tyrone, wait. You and everyone else at the school have been making assumptions about me. I heard you. But you know what? I'm not rich. My family barely has enough money to keep me in pointe shoes.
Yeah, right. That's why you show up every day that long black limo.
My father's a chauffeur. He drives me here on his way to work. And I don't speak French either. I barely even know what merci madame means.
And I've been putting on this act.
Because I was scared.
Scared of what? The best dancer in the school, Iris.
Scared no one would like me.
Well, I like you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Diet. What's that? I eat food, and I eat.
It's a joke, Carmen.
I'm laughing.
Yo, Mr. Miles! I need to be excused from class on Friday. See, they're doing a revival of West Side Story, and I am like perfect for the role of Anita.
I'm sorry, Carmen, but the last thing you need right now is another character to hide behind.
What's that supposed to mean?
Carmen, the first rule of acting is know thyself. If you don't learn to deal honestly with your own emotions, then you'll just be another pretty face that no one cares about.
You're wrong about me, Mr. Myers. I'm gonna make it, because I know what it takes. From now on, I only got three things to worry about. Me, myself, and I. One day, you're gonna see my name on the lights. Carmen Diaz.
Sparkle, girl, sparkle.
I'm talking Broadway, movies.
Atlantic City, Radio City.
People are gonna shiver when they see me coming.
Shiver, honey, shiver.
They'll say, there she goes, Carmen. Not the movie, not the opera, but the human being.
Ain't she the picture of a real life star? You'll want to follow her whoever you are. And there she goes. She's passing you. You better hurry if you wanna look. Maybe you'll get her in your autograph book. She's passing you. Reach out to touch. Don't be shy.
Your mother.
All right,
How about Shakespeare or The Two Gentlemen of Verona?
Oh, and which one would I play?
Would you stop being difficult?
I'm not being difficult. We spent a whole year investigating our own emotions, and you keep picking scenes I can't relate to.
Maybe you'd rather be scene partner than Joe.
That clown? No way. All I'm saying is we spent a whole year investigating our own emotions, and you keep picking scenes I can't relate to. Why can't we try something different?
Like what?
Like Troilus and Cressida. Or how about Cat on a Hot Tin Roof? Oh, I would just die to play Maggie the Cat. I have a copy right here in my bed.
What's this?
You gave it to me.
Last semester. Carry my headshot around?
Yes. No, I am mixing at home. What are you doing? Make way, don't!
For crying out loud, Serena. How are we going to get any work done if you keep acting like an adolescent?
What's wrong with acting like adolescents if that's exactly what we are?
Look, Serena, it's obvious that you and I didn't come from the same place. Maybe you should find yourself a new scene partner.
Tomorrow.
Thanks.
No, really good. Except for the second and third lines. They just don't blow.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I see what you mean. Want to try it again? Bring on tomorrow. Let it shine. The sun coming up on a beautiful day.
It's yours and mine. We can make a difference. It's not too late. Bring on tomorrow. We can't wait.
We're unreal.
You're crazy.
I'm crazy. We just struck gold. Can't you see? We're good for each other. I'm what your band needs.
I guess. After all, we just wrote our first song together.
Oh man, you are too much.
I'm in the band!
Oh, alright, look, I gotta go. I got an audition. But I'll catch you guys later.
Yeah, catch you later.
We've got it! We've definitely got it!
Now let's talk about the quality of movement. It should be lyrical but strong, like fire and ice. Hello, Esther. What brings you to the fourth floor?
I understand you've chosen Tyrone and Iris to feature in next year's junior festival.
They earned it.
Unfortunately, Tyrone won't be able to participate.
Say what?
I'm sorry, Tyrone. You failed sophomore English.
You flunked me? But it did all the work. Even during my term paper on time.
Unfortunately, it bore remarkable similarity to Iris's.
Wait a minute. Are you accusing me of cheating?
Tyrone and I studied together. So what if the papers are similar?
They weren't similar. They were identical.
Then why not accuse Iris?
Because she's a straight-A student. Let's be honest. Iris has been carrying you in your academic subjects for the entire year.
Nobody carries me. I do my homework in my own way.
You may think you do. But your reading is substandard. You couldn't possibly have written that paper.
Hey, forget this noise. I don't want to be no festival anyway.
Tyrone, wait. Wait.
You're not being fair, Esther. Tyrone reported in my class. He's motivated in my class. This young man has the potential to become a true artist.
A true artist that can hardly read. Let Tyrone pass his academic subjects. Then we'll talk about his living in the art.
No! Now!
Art is special to let you fool. Special fit down for breaking the fools. Fit for confinement and keep the fools. Art is so special.
What is the people of primitive fools? They learn what to do before breaking the fools. They know that the people's the finest of tools.
Thank you.
Don't be doing me no favors. I don't need the school, and I don't need you.
Tyrone! Wait! Wait!
Greta, he has made his decision. Now we'll have to live with it.
Do you really think I just let Tyrone walk away? After everything I've invested in him! Obviously, you don't know me very well.
Junior year!
Turned out pretty good.
Well, of course it did. With my words and your music, how could we lose?
Come on, we'll play for you.
So keep one eye on the music, with the other eye on me.
Alright, set for places, guys. Places. This is Sheinkopf. We're at places.
Have you seen Carmen?
Isn't she in the dressing room?
She should be on stage with me now. Excuse me, Schlomo, have you seen Carmen?
I don't know, Miss Bell. We came in together. Maybe she's in the bathroom.
Perhaps she's here.
Carmen! Where have you been?
Sorry, Miss Bell. I just went outside to get a breath of fresh air.
Well, breathe on your own time, not mine. Okay, let's get this show on the road.
All right, places. Mr. Sheinkopf, start the music, maestro.
I wanna make magic. I wanna strike lightning in the sky.
I wanna do things you can't be.
Your senses
in
real proud of you.
Thanks, Miss Bell.
Tyrone, I understand you passed sophomore English in summer school. I hope this time you did the work yourself.
Just gonna wait to bring me down, could you?
My goal is to see you succeed.
Sure got a funny way of showing it, but it don't matter. Not today. Because today, I'm flying high.
Was that really necessary?
I don't know. Only time will tell.
Made up your mind, and we'd less hear about it.
Please don't you start bugging me too.
Carmen, we're your friends. We care what happens to you.
Then be my friends and get off my case.
But you already know this guy.
Elliot Green came to New York to scout talent, and he found me. He has faith in me, which is more than I can say for you.
But what about the band? What about us?
I can't pass this up. Besides, the band ain't going nowhere.
Who says it's their showbiz?
He's a professional agent. He's got all kinds of things lined up for me in LA.
You know what your problem is? You want everything too fast. Instant fame. Unfortunately, that only happens in fairy tales.
You know, Carmen, the four of us, we could really bend some.
Thank you.
die. I want to die. Do you know what I go through day in and day out? There's the sore muscles and the back pain and the sweat. But worse than that, I feel like I can't eat.
Up on yourself.
much which manly devotion shows in this, for saints of hands that pilgrims' hands do touch, and palm to palm is holy palmer's kiss.
Yo, do it, baby!
Wait a minute, what's with the ad-libs?
Hey, I'm drawing from my own experience, okay?
But Romeo wasn't born in the Bronx!
Yeah, so what am I doing here?
I placed you in this role so you can stretch yourself.
Mr. Myers, my name's gonna cut it. You gotta replace me.
You're too busy thinking about yourself when you should be thinking about the beautiful girl standing right in front of you.
Excuse me, why may I ask, are you butting in?
I want to help.
Who says we need help?
We do, Storm. Knock yourself out.
I mean, just think about it. Romeo and Juliet grew up in the same small town. They may have seen each other every single day of their lives, but on this night, on this special night, it's as if he's seen her for the very first time. Maybe it'd make more sense if I showed you.
Yeah, maybe it would.
Oh, then, dear saint, let lips do what hands do. They pray ground fell, lest faith turn to despair.
Saints do not move, though grant for prayer's sake.
Thus from my lips, my prayer's effect I take. By thine, my sin is purged.
Well, let's see a show of hands. How many of you like this Romeo? Joe, you got your wish. Juliet, meet your new Romeo.
Hello, Romeo.
Right, you haven't had anything to say to me all semester. Why is that, Iris?
Okay, I'll make it simple. I don't want to be the loser. Cause what does that make me?
Oh, I get it. I see what this is about.
You use me, Tyrone. All those book reports I helped you with, why didn't you tell me you couldn't read?
What was I supposed to say? Hey, baby, come get me. I'm illiterate. Iris, you don't know what it's like. When you look at a book, you see words. When I look, I see garbage. I see noise. Thanks to Miss Sherman. That noise started to sound like music. Listen to this. I celebrate myself and sing myself. From what I assume, you shall assume. For every atom belonging to me, as good belongs to you. Walt Whitman, Leaves of Grass.
That's great, Tyrone. It's just one poem.
I'm not taking the easy way out. I'm repeating my senior year. I'll be the first to graduate from the new Lincoln Center School. I'm not a loser, Iris.
Ladies and gentlemen, the lyrics to our senior song were written by a very talented student, Carmen Diaz.
This is for you, Carmen. We'll always remember your name.
We have arrived at a moment in our lives where the future passes into our hands. We can find out, are we really strong enough to fulfill what the future demands?
We can stand on the edge and look out into space and be awed by the wonders we see.
We can all make a pledge that the whole human race
Sparrow.